Hi, it's Nikki here from Happy Hormones for Life. Today I am talking about B vitamins. We know we need them. I'm not sure if you know much about them. I certainly didn't when I was pre-nutrition and health. And I just thought there was maybe one B vitamin, B. But actually there are no less than 8 B vitamins, and we need to get them from our diet because they're absolutely crucial to our health, hormones and general well-being. B vitamins supply your energy, they balance your mood, they're involved in detoxification, they look after your hormones, they look after your brain health and a whole lot, and immune system and a whole lot more. So I'm going to go through which ones they are, what health benefits they offer and where to get them in your food. And also importantly, what forms to look for in your supplements, because not all B vitamins are equal. So what are the different ones? We've got vitamin B1, thiamine. It's needed to convert carbohydrates into energy. So you're definitely going to need this one if you're low in energy, as all the vitamins are actually, all the Bs actually. Best food sources for B1 are things like vegetables, nuts, seeds, beans, lentils, oats, all those kind of cool things, healthy foods basically. And your best supplement form is thiamine mononitrate or thiamine HCl or hydrochloride. That's the best, most absorbable form. Now, vitamin B2 is riboflavin. Now, that helps to metabolize carbs and essential fats into energy as well. So obviously, that's going to be a good source of energy for you. But it has a vital role to play in liver detoxification as well and immune system health. So also helpful for things like migraines and headaches, acne, muscle cramps, things like that. So B2, your best food sources are things like green leafy veg, which you got to be having in your diet anyway, chicken, fish, soy products, natural yogurt, eggs, things like that. The best supplement form of riboflavin is literally riboflavin or riboflavin 5-phosphate. B3 is your niacin, another really key one for your energy production, but also vital for your thyroid, your blood sugar balance, your mood, your nerve function, and your cell membranes. And it can also help to lower cholesterol, but don't rely on that, and obviously speak to your doctor if you've got high cholesterol. Best food sources for niacin are things like meat, fish, brown rice, peanuts, seeds, almonds, seaweed. You're kind of getting the gist with the food sources, right? B5 is next, and that's your pantothenic acid. So pantothenic acid is really vital for the production of your adrenal hormones, especially important to take B5 if you're under a lot of stress. Also needed for the production of your sex hormones, estrogen, progesterone, and testosterone. So a really key one if you're going through peri, because obviously that's you're bound to be sort of affected by stress and hormone changes. Best food sources for B5, avocados, we love avocados, mushrooms, soy products, bananas, cabbage, broccoli, your cruciferous veg, which are also good for your liver, kale, brown rice, eggs, poultry, sweet potatoes, natural yogurt. All the foods that we love to recommend in the programs that we run. So just, you know, focus on those kind of foods and you're good for B5, but obviously it gets used up by stress. So you might need extra if you have stress. The best supplement form is calcium pantothenate. Don't know if I've said that right. Pantothenate, whatever. B6 is your pyridoxine. So B6 is the building blocks for your protein and your DNA. So really good for mood, as it tends to stimulate serotonin, and absolutely essential in your detoxification of steroid hormones like estrogen. So that helps to reduce that risk of estrogen building up and proliferating, and then forming estrogen driven type cancers. Key roles for B6 also in brain health and your immune system. Best sources for that are spinach, walnuts, eggs, fish, poultry, beans, potatoes, bananas, chickpeas, all that lovely stuff. Best supplement form, pyridoxine HCl or pyridoxal 5-phosphate. So look for those two forms. By the way, if you want to know these, you know, if you can't remember what I'm saying, just go over to the blog. Everything's listed in the blog on my website. Vitamin B7 is the next one. That's biotin. So you might know it as biotin rather than B7. So as well as metabolizing your carbs, protein and fats into energy, it's another massively energy B-vit. Biotin has also been shown to help with blood sugar balance, and you may have seen it in things like for skin, hair and nail health. So if you've got hair loss, you might want to be looking at biotin. It's not the only one you want to be looking at, but it may be that. Best food sources, vegetables, nuts, seeds, beans, lentils and oats. And of course, the best supplement form is just biotin. That one's easy. The next one is vitamin B9 or folic acid. Now, folic acid is the synthetic form of folate. So folate is what your body uses to detox in your detoxification pathways. It breaks down something called homocysteine, which can cause inflammation. And it's really vital for mood and protecting your baby in pregnancy as well. We know that. So best sources of folate are asparagus, duck, leafy greens, bananas, beans, peas, peanuts, citrus fruits, your fruit and veg, basically. And the best supplement form is, I'm going to have a go at this. The methylated form of folate, which is 5-methyltetrahydrofolate or calcium L-methylfolate. There you go. Got my teeth in. Vitamin B12 is the last of your B-vits that you need to worry about, often known as cobalamin. So it's critical for energy production. I've talked about B12 before because my mum suffers from deficiency, so I'm on this one all the time, always testing my levels. Not just energy production, but nerve function, brain health. So deficiency in B12 can cause fatigue, dizzy spells, muscle weakness, tingling, low mood. Very often depression is B12 deficiency, not always, but it's one to look for. Confusion, kind of dizziness, loss of appetite, sometimes weight loss as well. So the best forms of B12 are animal products, unfortunately. No, you can't get B12 from vegetarian sources apart from things like nutritional yeast or yeast extract. Not much in there, I don't think. So you're looking at your dairy, your fish, your meat and your eggs. Vegans or vegetarians should absolutely get tested to identify any deficiencies, and you definitely should be supplementing. And the best supplement form is methylcobalamin. So there are some cheaper forms of B12, cyanocobalamin. You want to avoid those because the methyl one is the methylated version is really what you want. So B vitamins, you want to consider supplementing if you're a vegan or vegetarian. You don't eat many of the foods that I've been talking about, and hopefully if you're following me, you should be trying to eat more of those kind of foods. Or if you're over 40 and you're going through perimenopause or beyond, or if you've got a lot of stress, or you drink alcohol, because that's going to deplete things, or you have symptoms, low energy, brain fog, anxiety, bad periods, mood issues, muscle weakness or muscle cramps, dizziness, PMS, or some of the things I've mentioned in this video. If you've got any of those symptoms, you might want to be topping up your Bs. You have any kind of digestive issues because you could be on the best diet in the world and just not absorbing them, so you might want to be topping up with your Bs. They are a water-soluble B vitamins, so your body will take what you need and flush the rest out. You need supplementing if you have poor methylation. We can test that for you. Or if you have a family history of B12 deficiency or other B vitamin deficiencies, and of course if you're pregnant as well. You can choose a good B complex formula, but actually I prefer to take a good quality multi because it's got all your Bs in and it's got all those other vitamins and minerals you need, rather than just take the B complex and then have to worry about your zinc and your selenium and all the other things that you need. Okay, so just a good quality multi will provide those B vitamins in the right forms. I've got two here that I love. Nutri Advanced Multi Essentials for Women. If you go over to my page, my website and the shop, the supplements, it will take you to my collection, my top 5 collection. This is on there. And this is a new one called Feel Multivitamins. They're a really good brand. And the multivitamin that they do, slightly less amounts of B-vits, but all in the right forms as well. And they sort of like come in the post and you can subscribe and all that good stuff. So if you look for the good quality ones, they're going to get you the best results. That's why you want to be doing that. So I hope that was useful. Please do contact us if you need any help with testing or one-to-one nutritional support. We are here to help you. And of course, we're always here. So just contact us and we will get you some information. Take care. I'll see you soon.